A somber start as it's a last lap of victory for our late friend Robert Jeffries. The two-time modified champion lost his battle with cancer over the winter. And if I may say, Robert was one of the coolest cats I've ever had the pleasure of knowing. Time for racing, 40 laps for the sportsman. Robbie Brewer starts on the point. Lap 12, Bobo Brown finds trouble in the north turn. Lap 17, leader Robbie Brewer breaks his axle. It's a big spin on the backstretch. Tommy Neal is also involved. Lap 20, Derek Stoltz takes the lead over Michael Adams. Primetime Derek Stoltz holds off John Holloman for his first win in 2 years.
It's like you never left.
Never. Never went nowhere. Took a little break. It's redemption if I've ever had it right here. Man, I owe everything to everybody right here who helped me on this car. We're not done. This is just a start, man.
Burt Myers starts up front for the Hayes Jewelers 200, the longest race of the year. Lap 31 off a restart. Zach Brewer, Daniel Beeson, and Mike Norman all crack up in turn two. On the restart, second place runner Lee Jeffries cuts a tire. Lap 67, Tim Brown takes the lead on an outside pass and leads for the next 70 laps. But on lap 140, he goes to the pits for fresh tires, giving up the lead to Burt Myers. Fresh rubber and the crazy cone allow Brown to gain spots. And on the last lap, the rocket spins. It brings out the yellow, but freezes the field for a green-white checker finish. In overtime, Burt Myers holds off the hard-charging Tim Brown for his first win of the year.
How did you hold him off?
I don't know. I just tried to guard the bottom, and I still had a great race car, but, you know, 200-lap tires compared to 100-lap tires, it's hard to hold off, and Tim returned the respect that I gave him earlier in the race, and I expect to race with him like that all year. I mean, if you look in the history books, you know, this is just the beginning of what's going to be happening all year this year.
At Bowman Gray Stadium, Jeff Amernick, WXII, 12 Sports.